afternoon, friends. Today I will just in brief tell you about how I went through this test series, because I did this test series twice in 2014 as well as 2015. Okay, so I followed a basic strategy which I evolved in 2014, and I applied it in 15 as well. Okay, so as I told you earlier also, in this thing, PubEd also I followed the same thing, three things: consistency, revision and time management. Okay, consistency, I mean, there are some people who usually study public administration, or they are optional in 1 month only, and then they go for GS, or they will first study GS and then they will study public administration. But what I did, daily 4 hours for public administration. Okay, and in public ad, basically the most crucial thing is understanding the question. As sir told, you should attempt first those questions which you are very confident about. Okay, instead of 5 questions, even if you write 4.5 questions in mains, but if you answer to the point and what is the demand of the question, you will get very good marks. In 2014, I left almost 35 or 40 marks of public administration, but still I was able to secure 250 marks. But in 2015, that is this last year, I completed my full paper and I was confident that I will score almost 240 to 250, but this year 210. Okay, so what I found that maybe some of the questions were which I attempted, I was not able to write to the point answers of those questions. Whereas in my earlier attempt, I was able to write very good answers for 4 questions. Okay, so I think this is what which made the difference, because even though after leaving 35 marks, I was able to score 250. So the first and foremost thing is, whenever you are attempting the question, please understand the question carefully. So I think around 10 minutes minimum you will take just to select the questions that which you will attempt. Okay, and please invest some time at the starting only on selection of the questions, because you should not do this that okay, after investing 10 minutes in selecting the questions, while attempting the question you are switching the question. Yaar, isme 3 parts hai, I am only able to write 2 questions properly, so main ye wala question karta hu, aur fir kya hoga ki you will waste time in that question aur ek bhi question theek se nahi ho payega, kyunki उस समय आप पैनिक में रहोगे कि यार फटाफट ख़त्म करना है. ओके, तो थोड़ा सा इन्वेस्ट टाइम इन स्टार्टिंग ओनली इन सिलेक्टिंग द क्वेश्चन एंड देन अटेम्प्ट दोज क्वेश्चन. ओके, देन स्टिक टू स्टैंडर्ड बुक्स. देर इज़ नो शॉर्टकट इन PubEd ऑल्सो एज विच वॉज केस इन द GS. ऑलवेज स्टिक टू स्टैंडर्ड बुक्स, बिकॉज फ्रॉम स्टैंडर्ड बुक्स यू विल गेट द कीवर्ड्स. ओके, एंड देन वॉट यू कैन डू इज you can make a list of, for example, in GS, if you are making a list of cases for paper 2, in PubEd you can make list of important keywords or some of the concepts. For example, there is always confusion ki Bernard ne kya kya concepts diye the, so Bernard aur Likert mein, Argris aur Likert mein bahut confusion hota hai ki yaar kiske kya concept hai. So do multiple time revisions and make a list ki Foley ke 5 concepts the, uske baad आर्ग्रिस के ये थे, मैग्रेगर का ये थे, थ्योरी एक्स थ्योरी वाई जो था वो मैग्रेगर का था, ठीक है, लिकर्ट का था तो लिंकिंग पिन मॉडल था. ओके, तो जो भी इंपॉर्टेंट कंसेप्ट हैं यू शुड हैव अ लिस्ट ऑफ दोज कंसेप्ट, क्योंकि दिस इज द कंसेप्ट, दिस इज फॉर पेपर 1. फॉर पेपर 2 द इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड द क्रूशल थिंग इज अबाउट एग्जाम्पल्स. यू शुड इनकॉर्पोरेट एग्जाम्पल्स इन पेपर 2 एंड यू शुड ऑल्सो ट्राई टू लिंक कंसेप्ट ऑफ पेपर 1 विथ पेपर 2. So you should also make a list for examples which are to be used in paper 2, and this examples list will be updated continuously through newspaper. For example, Pragati karke ek initiative tha, hai na, so this can be very well used in paper 2. Okay, agar koi important suggestion hai editorial mein that about PRIs ko aap kaise improve kar sakte hain. Okay, jaise mapping, activity mapping wala ek article tha in some of the yojana, ki to improve some of the things at the ground grassroot level, activity mapping should be there. So is tarike ke concepts hain, you can use it in your paper. Okay, देर इज़ नो नीड टू मैंशन द सोर्स, तो ऐसा लगेगा कि आपका सजेशन है, ओके तो थोड़ा डिफरेंट लगेगा आंसर। तो थोड़ा सा टाइम इन्वेस्ट करके गूगल पे आप सर्च करिए, जैसे ओपी चौधरी के कुछ इनिशिएटिव्स थे छत्तीसगढ़ जो नक्सल अफेक्टेड एरिया है, फॉर एग्जांपल छूलो आसमान और सम ऑफ दी एग्जांपल्स ऑफ दिस सॉर्ट। सो टेक आउट सम टाइम और इससे रिलेटेड आप एग्जांपल्स की एक लिस्ट प्रिपेयर करो एंड रिवाइज दैट लिस्ट कंटिन्यूसली। फर्दर अगर न्यूज़ में कोई भी चीज़ आती है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल लास्ट ईयर गवर्नर वॉज इन न्यूज़, ओके उसका अपॉइंटमेंट, उसका रिमूवल, तो जो दो तीन कमिटीज़ हैं जिन्होंने गवर्नर से रिकमेंडेशन रिलेटेड रिकमेंडेशन दिए हैं, तो व्हाट यू शुड डू, यू शुड ट्राई टू इनकॉर्पोरेट दोज रिकमेंडेशन। तो पूरी MMPC जो रिपोर्ट है उसको पूरी निमात पढ़ो आप। अगर न्यूज़ में गवर्नर है तो गवर्नर से रिलेटेड रिकमेंडेशन सरकारिया की भी उठा लो, MMPC की भी उठा लो, सिलेक्टिव रीडिंग करो। अगर डिज़ास्टर या कुछ हुआ है तो डिज़ास्टर वाली थोड़ी सी ARC से पॉइंट उठा लो, एक मिश्रा पैनल बना था उसका रिपोर्ट। तो डायरेक्ट ऑथेंटिक जो सोर्सेज हैं यू शुड टेक आउट इन्फॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम द सोर्सेज। ओके दिस इज अबाउट पेपर टू। नाउ एज फार एज बुक्स फॉर PubEd इज कंसर्न, व्हाट आई डिड, आई फॉलोड दिस शेड्यूल ऑफ टेस्ट। अब इसमें सर ने क्या किया हुआ था कि क्लब किए हुए हैं टॉपिक, ओके तो व्हाट आई विल सजेस्ट यू इज टू गो इन द सिमिलर फैशन ओनली। क्यों? बिकॉज फॉर एग्जाम्पल जैसे फाइनेंशियल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन और फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट आर क्लब टुगेदर, ओके अब फाइनेंशियल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन इज ऑफ पेपर वन बट मैनेजमेंट इज ऑफ पेपर टू, बट दोनों के कंसेप्ट इंटर रिलेटेड हैं, तो इट इज़ बेटर कि आप फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट और एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन साथ में पढ़ें रादर देन रीडिंग सेपरेटली। सेम गोज विथ पर्सनल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एंड सिविल सर्विसेज, ओके सो यू शुड ट्राई टू क्लब दीज टॉपिक्स टुगेदर। PubEd का सिलेबस एकदम दिमाग में छपा होना चाहिए और अपने सामने जब भी आप तैयारी कर रहे हो, चाहे GS हो चाहे PubEd, उसका सिलेबस जो जो टॉपिक होता जाए, जैसे वी यूज टू डू इन क्लास 10th, जस्ट पुट अ टिक, एक बार रिविजन हो गया एक टिक, दूसरी बार रिविजन हो गया दूसरा टिक, ओके फिर फॉर एग्जांपल जैसे चैप्टर 1 है इंट्रोडक्शन, और जो फर्स्ट टेस्ट होगा दैट विल बी अबाउट इंट्रोडक्शन एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव थॉट बिहेवियर एंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, ओके ये टेस्ट होंगे आपके फर्स्ट टू। तो जस्ट इंश्योर कि जो फर्स्ट टेस्ट है उसके लिए आप इंट्रोडक्शन में जो भी टॉपिक्स हैं, जैसे NPA है, NPM है, पब्लिक चॉइस अप्रोच है, तो रीड इट फ्रॉम 2 or 3 सोर्सेज जो भी आपका बुक्स हैं एंड रीड इट मल्टीपल टाइम्स। उस समय फिर आप ये मत करिएगा कि उस टाइम मैं पर्सनल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन पढ़ लूँ, वो बोर हुए तो फिर आपने बोला यार PSU छोटा सा पार्ट है ये पढ़ के ख़त्म कर लेता हूँ, ऐसा मत करिएगा। इंट्रोडक्शन एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव थॉट बिहेवियर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ये सब फिर आप इकट्ठा पढ़िए, ओके और NPA, NPM ये एटलीस्ट एक दो सोर्सेज से पढ़िए, शर्मा सदाना जो स्टैंडर्ड बुक्स हैं, ओके ओके तो व्हाट यू कैन डू इन फर्स्ट टू टेस्ट, यू शुड रीड ओनली फ्रॉम स्टैंडर्ड बुक, ओके 2-3 स्टैंडर्ड बुक एंड मल्टीपल टाइम्स, फॉर एग्जांपल NPA, NPM, बिकॉज पब्लिक चॉइस अप्रोच इज़ वेरी टफ, इट इज़ वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू कॉम्प्रिहेंड दैट हाउ वी विल अप्लाई इट, ओके सो इफ यू आर फाइंडिंग इट डिफिकल्ट नो प्रॉब्लम, गो टू बेसिक बुक, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इग्नू, रीड पब्लिक चॉइस अप्रोच फ्रॉम देयर। सो वॉट एवर टॉपिक यू फाइंड डिफिकल्ट जस्ट रीड स्पेसिफिकली फ्रॉम अ स्टैंडर्ड बुक, ओके रादर देन रीडिंग कवर टू कवर ऑफ ईच एंड एवरी बुक, इट इज़ मोर एडवाइजेबल टू गो फॉर अ स्पेसिफिक टॉपिक, फॉर एग्जाम्पल सिविल सर्विसेज न्यूट्रैलिटी, इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू राइट 10 लाइन्स अबाउट इट देन यू आर वीक इन दैट टॉपिक, सर्च दैट सिविल सर्विसेज न्यूट्रैलिटी इन शर्मा एंड सदाना, रीड 3 पेजेस ऑफ सिविल सर्विसेज न्यूट्रैलिटी 2-3 टाइम्स एंड देन गिव द टेस्ट, ओके सो दिस इज हाउ यू शुड गो अबाउट। सो आई विल टेल अबाउट स्टैंडर्ड बुक्स फॉर डिफरेंट टॉपिक्स एंड द वे यू हैव टू रीड द बुक्स, आई विल टेल दैट रादर देन गोइंग फॉर कवर टू कवर जस्ट द स्पेसिफिक टॉपिक्स फ्रॉम दैट स्टैंडर्ड बुक। सो रादर देन रीडिंग 8 or 10 डिफरेंट बुक्स और फ्रॉम इंटरनेट 8 or 10 डिफरेंट थिंग्स, रीड 2 or 3 स्टैंडर्ड बुक्स बट थरोली, so that your concept is clear, because whenever in exam a question will come, it is very difficult to comprehend that from where that question has come, but if your basics are very sound then you can attempt that question. So you should be thorough in your preparation that okay PCA, the public choice approach, whether it promotes politics administration dichotomy or it refuses politics administration dichotomy. So at such a level your concept should be clear that what is different between न्यू वेबेरियन स्टेट एंड अ वेबेरियन स्टेट और पोस्ट व्हाट वर द पोस्ट स्ट्रक्चरल थ्योरीज. ओके सो दीज थिंग्स यू शुड बी कंसेप्चुअली वेरी क्लियर. ओनली देन यू विल बी एबल टू आंसर इन पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. बिकॉज वॉट इज द मोस्ट डिफिकल्ट पार्ट इन पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑप्शनल इज टू अंडरस्टैंड द क्वेश्चन. देर इज नो पॉइंट इफ यू विल सर्च अ पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन ऑन नेट यू विल फाइंड अ बुक फॉर दैट. देन यू विल रीड दैट पर्टिकुलर बुक एंड देन वॉट विल हैपन दैट ईयर नथिंग विल कम फ्रॉम दैट बुक. ओके सो रादर देन दिस इट इज मोर एडवाइजेबल टू गो फॉर स्टैंडर्ड बुक स्टैंडर्ड थिंग्स एंड ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन योर नॉलेज. What you should do, you should narrow down your choices while practicing or while writing the answer. You should think that okay, this question is not from organization, this is not from administrative behavior, okay, this thing was not given by Foley, this must be between McGregor and Argyris. Sab do mein se koi ek hai. Out of two only one thing is there, okay, and out of those two things also you should narrow down. Okay, Argyris gave these three concepts, he gave these three concepts, so this is more close to Bernard. So this is how you can attempt the question. Otherwise, if you will go for what each and every theorist has said, it will beyond your comprehension to read each and everything about the theorist. Okay. So for introduction, I read Mohit Bhattacharya and IGNU. IGNU not cover to cover, only specific things, because I was not very much clear about PCA, that how to apply it. So I read IGNU. For example, public policy also, some of the portion of public policy, especially everybody is aware about policy formulation, okay, policy implementation, but the things about policy monitoring, policy evaluation, we don't get anywhere the material about this. So go to IGNU, just read about policy formulation or policy implementation, whichever area you find you are weak in that. Okay, then administrative thought discussion in class, I found it very useful, and notes, my personal notes, because earlier I used, way back in 2-3 years back, I did my paper one from Mohanty sir, so that class notes I read multiple times. So wherever you have done your basic things or basic coaching, that class notes you should revise more and more, so that in examination that situation should not come, that whether this concept was given by Argyris or Likert. That fundamental dilemma should not come. Otherwise, 1 or 2 minutes is wasted in that thing. And after writing the answer, you realize, hey, this was given by some other person. And then you try to modify your answer. Wo dhoond dhoond ke you will scratch it. Ki yaar, isko change karte hain. Okay. So that thing should not be done. Because from your paper, your conceptual clarity is projected. Okay. If there is no single cutting in your answer paper, it will give a very good impression. Okay. Then for administrative behavior, Sharma and Sadhana I referred. So in Sharma and Sadhana also, in small 1-1, 2-2 pages, each and everything about Foley, difference between leadership and management, administrator and manager, these things are given. So basics you should read, motivation. Okay. Because we read hi-fi things, and if somebody asks or if question comes, what is the difference between an administrator and manager, we are not able to write a crisp answer in 2 or 3 lines. Why I am telling you this? Because in interview also they will ask you the same thing. Okay, your optional is public administration. Okay, you are going to be an administrator. Okay, so you have done MBA also. Okay, so just tell me what is the difference between an administrator and a manager. So at that point of time, you don't have luxury of 200 words of explaining that thing to the interviewer. You have just 50 seconds. In that, you have to give a crisp answer. In my earlier interview, I was asked about, have you read ARCs? My next answer was, yes, sir. Okay. So, randomly, they asked anything from any of the ARCs. And luckily, I was able to answer. They asked me about new public management, new terrorism, then agencification, its application in current time, that if the government is doing reforms, so how you can see the ARCs being applied in those reforms. So those all things will be discussed in class. Okay. So what I am telling you, if you will write precisely in your mains examination, if you will read from a standard book, it will help you a lot in interview. Because at that point of time, you can in calm and composed manner revise your optionals when other people will be reading they are optional. Okay, because public administration, if you are optional, you have to be on your toes in interview, because they expect that they will ask a particular question from practical field. For example, how will you integrate scheduled tribes or people of Northeast to mainland? Then you have to give some good reasons or good answers. And if you have read ARCs well, then you can give a very good answer. Okay. Then accountability and control also, Sharma and Sadhana plus newspaper. Because in accountability and control, some current examples you can incorporate very well. Okay, because every day we read that there was lack of accountability, there was diffusion of accountability, because of which a particular scheme failed. There is a topic in GS2 also, that evaluation of government schemes and other things. So those examples of paper 2 you can incorporate in paper 2 in PubEd. Okay, and same things of PubEd you can apply in GS also. Then for administrative law, I referred Sharma and Sadhana, and just search on internet. There is a small PDF or a manual on administrative law by DOPT. Okay, so DOPT manual is there on administrative law. It's a very good manual. In simple language, they have given some of the important judgments on administrative law. What is difference between administrative law and diocese administrative law, Android administrative, all those things they have given. Okay, then as far as CP and development dynamics goes, you should read both these topics simultaneously from Mohit Bhattacharya, and there are two books of Mohit Bhattacharya, New Horizons of Public Administration. So that I read cover to cover. Another is Social Theory, orange color cover is there, I think. So only 3-4 chapters from that book. Okay. And current examples can be incorporated in this CP and development dynamic. Okay, because good governance, e-governance, all these, or digital form of governance, all these are like evolution of development administration. Okay, so all these things will be coming in development dynamic. Then personal administration and civil services, you should read it simultaneously. You should club these topics. For this, civil services, Arora and Goyal. For paper 2, Arora and Goyal is the standard book, and Sharma and Sadhana for personal administration, plus ARCs, personal administration. No need for reading about US, Germany, etc. Okay, just read India specific things, and the ARCs will reduce a lot. Plus, whichever new committee is coming, you should incorporate its findings also. For example, Kiran Agrawal committee, okay, and any other committee which is in news. Just don't remember the name of that committee, but some crucial and important recommendations also. And always remember that why that particular committee was formulated for. Okay. Then for public policy, Mohit Bhattacharya, newspaper, because plenty of things about policy comes in newspaper. And IGNU, some of the notes from IGNU. You can draw flow chart or diagrams from you can take it from that IGNU material. Okay. Further, I will say that there are some unique chapters in IGNU that you should refer. For example, Gandhian thought, you should refer from that IGNU material. Okay, because these topics you will find not in any other book, only in IGNU. Okay, and these things you can incorporate very well in answers, and you can link paper 1 and paper 2. For example, Gandhian thought. Okay. So whether Gandhiji promoted the welfare state or state, okay, or not, what good governance was according to Mahatma Gandhi. Okay, so these sort of things you will find in that IGNU material. So this you can very well use in paper 2 as well as paper 1. Then you should also use some of the things from paper 1. For example, for police reform, linking pin model of Likert you can use, okay, in paper 2. But always remember that there is a vocabulary for paper 2 and vocabulary for paper 1. Paper 1 is more theory oriented. So for NPM, there is a specific definition you should write. So whenever in paper 1 you are writing, you should write NPM, NPM, NPM. But when you are dealing with paper 2, you should write new economic policy, liberalization, globalization. Okay. So don't overuse the word NPM in paper 2. Otherwise, that paper 2 answer will look like paper 1. Okay. Then techniques of administration, Mohit Bhattacharya plus internet. Then financial administration and financial management from Sarman Sadana, ARC and Nicholas Henry. In Nicholas Henry, there is a single page in which he has differentiated what are the different techniques of that accounting and budgeting. Okay, there is a single page, you should read that page. Okay, how the budgeting was evolved. Plus, selected chapters from Nicholas Henry and Stephen Robbins. So, Stephen Robbins, leadership, that leadership chapter is very well, it is given in Stephen Robbins. Apart from that, some of the theories like that Potter-Lawler theory, which is very hard to understand, okay, that is given in Stephen Robbins very well. Okay, then apart from that, two or three more new forms of leadership, okay, that social charismatic model, two, three new things are given in Stephen Robbins. And from Nicholas Henry, you should read that Evolution of Public Administration. So there are that six paradigms you must have studied. But the problem is that we are not able to apply that paradigm. We think that it is of no use. We just link and mug up that locus is present, focus is absent, locus is absent. Like there is alternate sequence for that. Okay. But we don't know how to apply it. Okay. So here in test series, you will be able to apply those things which you have read in theory. For example, you have to identify a context, that a particular context, a statement is given, then you have to identify that, okay, this statement refers to the period of 1920s and 30s when there was period for principles of administration. So at that point of time, there was locus was absent and focus was present because administration is public, nothing, administration is same, nothing public about it. So all those things. So you will recollect that the context of that particular statement and then write that at that point of time, the public administration was, identity was in crisis and so and so, and then you can write your good answer. Or else if it is written that during the times of turmoil, the identity of public administration was threatened and all that statement is given, then you should identify that, okay, it is talking about the second phase of the public administration. So here you should use Nicholas Henry's. According to Nicholas Henry's paradigm, it is paradigm 2. So examiner will identify that, okay, he has hit the bullseye, he has understood the question. Never ever do that, you should make up a spree and then you are writing the crux. Always write the crux at the top only. Okay, and then you should ensure that examiner gets the idea that the student has understood the question. And always remember that give a different perspective, even though if it is not asked in the question, give a different vision, an additional vision or perspective in your answer. Even though the solution is not asked, give solution. Okay. Even if something is not asked in the question, just with the help of connecting words, however, in near future we can see these things happening. Okay. So a positive end, an optimistic end of the answer conclusion should be given in PubEd also, and try to incorporate an additional perspective. Even though something is not asked in the question, just in two or three lines you should incorporate that thing in your answer. Okay, then for paper 2, Arora and Goyal is, I think, is the standard book. Apart from that, D.D. Basu, because Lakshmikant is good for prelims. But I will say that you should study D.D. Basu, not cover to cover, but selected chapters. For example, Working of the Constitution and 2-3 other chapters from D.D. Basu. And because from here you will get the case laws, the citations and all those things, which will be helpful in paper 2. Okay. Then ARCs plus committees you have to read. Not all ARCs, but if you will read many of the ARCs, that will be useful for GS also. For example, on terrorism, for RTI, Sevuttam, all those things are given in ARC. So if you will write those things in your answer, it will give a look of public administration, because the language of ARC is very good. And not just once, you have to read ARCs twice or thrice. So so that you can utilize that language, that keywords. No need of using flowery language in public administration. But even if you are writing in simple English, some of the keywords you should mention. For example, rather than minister, if you will write public representative or political executive, it will look good. It will look as if a student of public administration is writing the answer. Okay. So rather than secretary, if you will write permanent executive, the relationship between the public political executive and permanent executive is defined by Article 53. This is given in your ARC. So it will give a very what you can say, a good quality or content to your answer. Sorry? Yeah, don't make notes in the first reading. At least one, read it once or twice, highlight the important point, and then you can make note in one or two pages of ARC. You can make a mind map. For example, for ethics, there is a legal framework, societal framework, okay, institutional framework. In institutional framework, CBI, CVC, okay, Lokpal, Lokayuk, then again mind map. Are you getting me? For example, if you have read twice or thrice ARC of ethics, then you will societal framework, legal framework, okay, then institutional framework. So legal mein there are laws. In laws also you will, after two or three readings, you will very well make the structure. For example, initially there was TADA, then POTA, okay, after this UAPA, okay, 67, then it was amended, then PMLA, okay. See how much matter you are getting from ethics. Social framework, in social framework, individual, ethics of individual, minister, civil servants, in ministers also MPs, MLAs, okay. So this is the mind map. This you can make only after reading twice or thrice the ethics. Then you will never face dearth of material that what I have to write. Here legal, TADA, this, institutional framework, CBI, PVC, Lokpal, Lokayuk at state level. Then at state level, does your state has Lokayuk? Is it effective or not for interview purposes? Okay, so see how the linkages is going on. So in same way for personal, for financial administration, same thing if you will read twice or thrice, all these things can be written in one single page. And that framework will be very clear in your mind, that mind map. And then you will revise just once prior to examination. And even if you don't have time, if you will, how much time will it take? Not more than 1 or 2 minutes to write this structure. That particular person will understand that he has a comprehensive knowledge. Hardly 2 minutes this will take to draw in your answer. And when in panicking situation, in last 10 minutes, you have to attempt 3 questions, this will come handy. Yeah, for Kunchi Commission also, rather than reading all recommendations, read for governor, read for other things. Yeah, okay. So this is the thing, and what you should do that if there is a gap of 7 days between one test and another, then read for another test, whatever the syllabus, in 7 days only, in that 4 hours, rather than thinking that 9 or 10 hours I will devote for PubEd. So daily 4-5 hours, whole syllabus will be complete within a week. Go, give the test, never miss the test, or think that, okay, I will bring that copy at home, I will write it, and then I will go. Okay, please don't do that, those kind of things. Attempt all the tests. After writing that test, next test, start studying for next test. Just a day before discussion, just revise all those things. When you come to class, when sir will discuss, jot down the things in your paper. Okay, once 6 papers are over, just do a spiral of those papers. So 6 papers, one spiral, 6 paper, another spiral. And then prior to exam, just rather than going after full books, read your papers. At least thrice you should have read your own paper, you should have read your own answer. So that you should get a feel that, okay, every time I write the same point in this question, what are the mistakes? Because if you will write once and you will not revise it, I am sure even if the same question is repeated in the same test series, in the comprehensive test, you will commit the same mistake and you will not write that answer. Until unless you will revise it. So जस्ट 1 month प्रायर टू योर मेन्स और 15 days प्रायर टू मेन्स डोंट रीड एनीथिंग न्यू, जस्ट रिवाइज ऑल द न्यूज़पेपर्स, सॉरी न्यूज़पेपर्स टेस्ट पेपर्स विच यू हैव रिटन, ओके. इफ यू विल प्रोसीड इन एन ऑर्गेनाइज्ड मैनर, इन अ प्रॉपर मैनर, यू वोंट पैनिक, यू विल रिमेन काम एंड कंपोज इवन 15 or 20 days प्रायर टू योर एग्जामिनेशन. एंड दिस इज मोस्ट क्रूशियल, बिकॉज इफ यू आर नॉट काम एंड कंपोज इनफ यू विल स्पॉइल यूर पेपर, बिकॉज वैन यू विल कम आउट ऑफ द एग्जामिनेशन यूर फ्रेंड हुज टेकन फिलोसफी विल से यार पेपर वन वॉज वेरी इजी, एंड यू विल योर हार्ट विल संग दैट ओ यार पवैड वॉज सो टफ. सो नेवर एवर ब्रिंग दैट थिंग इन यूर माइंड, बिकॉज अगर ऐसा रहता तो 100% रिजल्ट फिलोसफी का रहता, बट दिस इज नॉट ट्रू. ओके, दिस टाइम रैंक 6 इज फ्रॉम पबैड, ओके, माइन वॉज फ्रॉम पबैड, वन ऑफ माई फ्रेंड शी वॉज ऑल्सो फ्रॉम लुकमान, शी स्कोर्ड 136 रैंक, ओके 187. सो देयर हैज बीन सिलेक्शन फ्रॉम पबैड, दिस इज नॉट दैट, एंड बिलीव मी यू विल गेट सम काइंड ऑफ एडवांटेज इन एथिक्स एंड जी एस स्पेशली पेपर टू इफ यू हैव अ गुड बैकग्राउंड ऑफ पबैड. ओके, सो एंड डोंट कमिट दैट मिस्टेक दैट इफ इन ऐसे अ टॉपिक कम्स विच इज रिलेटेड टू पबैड, you are attempting that topic and you are writing PubEd in that. Don't commit that mistake. Okay. That's why pick a topic which is not of your option. Because if it's your topic related to your optional, you tend to get emotional and write each and everything in that essay. Okay. So, just ensure that you revise at least twice or thrice your test paper. Okay. And if you have any other doubt, you can just note down my mail address. You can ping me and I can share some GS answers and essays, and my PubEd answers are with sir. There is one bundle of 6 or 7 test papers of PubEd. My answers are with sir. You can, if you want, you can get it Xerox. Okay. And if you want another spiral of from 7 to 12 tests, I have it at my home. Somehow if sir arranges, I can send it to sir, or sir can get it Xerox. So my mail address is naman.upadhyaya@gmail.com. Okay. If you find any kind of problem in PubEd or GS, I can try to help you out, because I know this PubEd optional people are a bit scared. So I will again say you that please don't get carried away by your paper 1 or paper 2. After attempting your paper 1, if you are coming out and if your friends are telling that yaar mera paper bahut acha gaya hai and my optional was philosophy or geography, don't give a damn, because it is the final selection which will matter. Don't get panicked that your paper 1 has been screwed, and because of that you will spoil your paper 2 also, because you never know that how many marks you will score in UPSC. So best thing is rather than having any preconceived notions or making a mental block, just read in an organized manner, complete your syllabus well in time, read every day public administration 3 to 4 to 5 hours or 4 hours, okay, and give test in an proper honest manner. Okay, thank you. Yeah, see, if you will read multiple times, then you will realize, okay, this particular theory can be utilized in police reforms or in paper 2 or paper 2, this particular unit. When you will read it multiple times, you will automatically get a hold, and from current affairs also you can realize that when this new government came, it abolished many of the empowered committees, okay, minimum government, maximum governance. So what is it is doing? It is streamlining. Many of the same departments are, it is clubbing together. So this is the kind of organization of paper 1, but this is being applied in paper 2. So you have to keep your eyes and ears open, and while reading the newspaper, just try to link of things of paper 1 or paper 2 that, okay, I can use this thing in, for example, corruption. You can use very well Fredericks, okay, because the society is in transition. So these things you have to apply while reading the newspaper, and just in newspaper only you should just tick mark and write use it in public administration. This can be used in ethics. Okay, thank you.